Hello everyone and welcome back. This is Paul from TechLink and I've been getting a lot of comments from you guys on some of my previous videos related to the Google Authenticator app with all kind of questions regarding the usage of the app, the secret key transfer and recovery ways and so on. And in this video I would like to show you how to set up and use the Google Authenticator app and hopefully answer all of your questions. So make sure to watch through the whole video to find out everything you need to know about Google Authenticator and two-factor authentication. Now, for the purpose of this video, I'm gonna be using my Android phone, but this can be done on every mobile device from tablets to iPhones and iPads. It's going to look exactly the same, so don't worry if you're not using the same device as I am. So the first thing that you want to do is head over to the Play Store and search for Authenticator. Now what you're going to see is there are a lot of Authenticator apps which serve for the exact same purpose, but we're going to use the Google Authenticator mainly because it's like the standard app to use for two-factor authentication. So go ahead and download the app. Once you've downloaded Google Authenticator, open it and you'll notice that it's a really simple app. It's not that complicated to use. Now the first time you open it, it will ask you to either scan a QR code or enter a setup key, which will take us to the next step, how to set up a two-factor authentication on one of our accounts. I'm gonna use my Instagram account to give you an example on how to do it, since I don't have the 2FA activated for that account. So if I tap on the icon of my profile picture and tap these three lines at the top right corner of the screen and select settings, we're going to see a security tab. And this is what we are looking for. No matter what account you are using, whether it's an app or website, the two-factor authentication will be mainly located within the settings and the security tab. So if I select security, we're going to see there's a two-factor authentication option. And if I tap on that, they will ask us to choose how we want to receive the security codes, either to an authentication app or text message. But for the purpose of this video, we're going to use the app. Also, Instagram will check if I have one and will automatically create an account within the authenticator. But most of the times you will get a secret key or QR code which you need to insert in the app. So if I toggle this switch on and click next and press OK to save key, you will see an account has been added in the Google Authenticator app, which will generate a new 6-digit code every 30 seconds or so, which you need to copy and go back to your app and insert it in there. And now your two-factor authentication is on. So every time you log in from a device they don't recognize, they will ask you for one of these codes in addition to your password. And now for the most important part of this video, make sure to save your secret key or your QR code. I can't stress this enough. Like I said before, most of the times when you activate the 2FA, you will get a secret key or QR code which you should save and keep somewhere safe before you even finish the setup process. Now, as you've probably noticed if you paid attention to the video, we haven't received the secret key during the setup of the 2FA on my Instagram account. So what you need to do in this case is go back to settings and select security and tap on two-factor authentication, and you will see there's a new tab with additional methods to log in securely. So if we select that, we're going to see a backup codes tab which will give us 5 recovery codes which can only be used once in case our phone gets lost or we accidentally delete the Google Authenticator app. these work slightly different, meaning that we won't use them to set up a new 2FA account within the Authenticator app, but we are going to use them as a recovery way in case we lose access to our account. So they are just as important as the secret key, as they will help you regain access to your account. So make sure to keep them safe, write them down, take a screenshot, whatever you do, just make sure you save them for future use. And to show you how it would work in real life, let's say I want to log in to my Instagram after I've already logged out. I'm going to be asked for that two-factor authentication, that six-digit code. So I'm gonna head over to the Authenticator app and copy that key and insert it in the app. And as you can see, I managed to log in back to my account. Another thing worth mentioning is that these codes will only work for your Instagram account. So for every other website or app like Twitter or Facebook or your investment accounts or whatever, whichever service that supports two-factor authentication, you will have to repeat the same process again. Activate it from the security settings and use the secret key or QR code to add a new 2FA account in the Google Authenticator app. And with this, I think I managed to cover everything you need to know on the setup and usage of the Google Authenticator app. But if you have any other questions, let me know in the comment section. Also, if you would like to find out more about the Authenticator app, check out my other videos where I talk about how you can transfer your 2FA account from one device to another, or how to fix some of the issues you might encounter. And that's it for this video. If you enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up or share it with someone you think might benefit from it. And if you would like to see some similar tutorials, please subscribe to the channel. And like always, thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.